is your First Alert 5 weather with Mike Daniels.
Haze and smoke particles really thick over parts of the Pikes Peak region today. So thick in Colorado Springs, hard to even make out Pikes Peak. Visitors were wondering where America's mountain. Well, there it is right there. Finally broke out today. Pueblo also a little on the hazy side, and it was hot as well. Your big weather story. This is your next weather maker. A little better chance of seeing some thunderstorms around here tomorrow. We'll have more low-level moisture. That's the fuel for thunderstorms, and a disturbance is going to move across the area tomorrow afternoon. So still a good share of sunshine as we work through the day. More sunshine during the morning than in the afternoon, and then those afternoon thunderstorms will fire up across parts of the viewing area. Not everyone will get a PM thunderstorm, but a much better chance tomorrow than what we had today. 5% chance of seeing severe thunderstorms from I-25 all the way out to the Kansas border. All right, tonight, very quiet out there. Dry over the Springs, Pueblo down to Trinidad, all the way out to the Kansas border. Thought you'd find this interesting. Hurricane Bud off the coast of Mexico right there. Some of the models bringing some of this moisture into our area, into the state of Colorado over the weekend. We'll have a south to southwest flow. So that should entice remnants of Hurricane Bud into our area. That could really help with that 416 fire burning just to the north of Durango. This is just after midnight tonight. This is one of our high resolution models. It's been really consistent in popping a thunderstorm over parts of Colorado Springs and El Paso County after midnight tonight. This is 1 to 1:30. Still seeing at least the possibility of a thunderstorm. I think it's a long shot, but just wanted to make you aware of the possibility you could get a loud wake-up call with some thunder and lightning after midnight tonight through about 3 o'clock in the morning. By 8 a.m., lots of sunshine, temperatures into the 60s along the I-25 corridor. Those clouds really start to thicken up during the afternoon hours. And again, thunderstorms will develop with more moisture across our area tomorrow. Could see a line of thunderstorms from El Paso County all the way down into the Sangre de Cristos tomorrow afternoon. That stuff will push to the east. And just be aware of the possibility some of those thunderstorms could contain hail tomorrow afternoon. Pueblo, hot stuff today. 94, the afternoon high. In the Springs, we hit 87. Average this time of year only 78 degrees. Still really warm out there tonight, especially along the Arkansas River from Pueblo out to the Kansas border. 74 is the current temperature in Colorado Springs. Lows tonight quite a bit warmer than what we had last night. Those temperatures warmer than what we should have this time of the year. The wind is not going to be a problem around here tomorrow. South breeze during the afternoon, 10 to 15 miles per hour. Of course, if you're near a thunderstorm, it could get much stronger than that. And afternoon highs again tomorrow, hotter than what we should have this time of the year. In Colorado Springs, it's really going to get hot on Thursday. 92 the afternoon high, enough water in the atmosphere to pop a PM thunderstorm. Then over the weekend, continued opportunities for getting some of that rain we're hoping for. And look at those temperatures really start to fall off. Cold front comes in Monday, so highs Monday and Tuesday only in the 70s in the Pueblo area. Really hot for the rest of the week, into the weekend Thursday. That'll be the hottest day you'll have to deal with. Still a chance of getting a PM thunderstorm Thursday. By Sunday, though, here comes thunderstorm opportunities again, and it will cool nicely by Monday and Tuesday, only into the 80s. More low-level moisture early next week, and that'll support at least the possibility of landing some of that rain we've been hoping for so desperately bad. Canyon City, a PM thunderstorm possible the next couple of afternoons over the weekend. Not out of the question to see those thunderstorms. That pattern will actually continue into the middle part of next week with cooler temperatures. In Woodland Park, I'm going to keep a daily chance of getting a PM thunderstorm in your forecast all the way into Tuesday of next week, and take a look at those temperatures falling off by Monday and Tuesday highs only into the 60s. All right, guys, I want to wrap this up with one of Mike's fun weather facts. Today is June the 12th. Yep. On this date in 1979, Monument had 4 inches of snow.
Aww,
unbelievable.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
It can't happen.
Mother Nature never fails to impress around here.
Why not this year?
Yeah, that'd be
Come
nice.
Come on.
Thanks, Mike.
All right.